Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to do my thumb, and this will help complete the look of the angel theme. Nice wintry angel theme. Keeping it quite godly. Let's crack on. So I've already prepped my nail, so I've removed the surface shine and I'm going to fit a sculpting form. We're going to do it the same shape as the others, so we're going to do that sort of ballerina slash mandrel. I'm going to get it nice and secure. I'm going to dehydrate. I don't like thumbs.
Why?
They're just so big, aren't they? Mind you, it'd probably look a bit weird if they were really small, wouldn't they? Like as humans with little tiny thumbs. So I'm going to build out a clear platform. Very thin. Going to put a little bit of clear on the natural nail.
Why do you sometimes put clear on the natural nail?
Well, when I'm using an acrylic with such high pigment, I like to put a thin layer of clear down because it gives me greater adhesion. Now we're going to use Blue Lagoon, just like we have with these ones towards this part. But we're going to do some cutting. So at this stage, you just need to make sure your cuticle's nice and neat. Don't worry about everything being thick, because we want a little bit of thickness because we're going to do some cutouts. So you're just going to drag it down. It looks like we're doing a short thumb.
It does, doesn't it?
It looks horrible, that, doesn't it? A big, wide, short thumb. We're not going to leave it like that. We're going to use a blade. I have got a craft knife. Sorry. You can use a craft knife or you can use a cuticle blade. And what I'm going to do is go straight down there and there. And here.
Oh, you're brave.
Do you know what? Because I've got that clear there, I know I'm not going to slice through my own nail. This is in the middle, it will be more difficult to remove. If it's at the edge, it is a lot easier to remove. And say bye bye to him. Then we're going to do the same with this one. Bye bye.
So why didn't you just sculpt those little bits then, rather than...
It's just a bit easier to get a straight edge. I could do. I have the ability. But not everybody does have the ability to get that sort of neat line. So you don't need no more of that Blue Lagoon for now. For the free edge, you've got the green, haven't you? We've been working with this gorgeous green. So I didn't want to do the typical kind of Christmassy winter nails. I wanted to do something a little bit different that kept the colours a bit, you know, a bit more interesting. Oh, and Cassidy said to me last night, "Mummy, those nails are too long." Why are you doing those nails so long? You know you can't do anything with nails that long, Mummy. I looks like. All right. I love it how my 8-year old tells me what I can and can't have on my nails.
Somebody's got to.
So all I'm doing here is just blending this up a little bit. So you want the thickness at the tip here, but you want this sort of just blended up. So you're going to use it a bit wetter when you start to do your blend. And we're going to use the Blue Lagoon again. Leave that quite thick there. So it's thick there, and then we're going to blend a little bit. Still want some thickness here. And I'm going to cut straight across. And remove that. And then I'm going to cut here. And then we're going to remove this. Then we're going to use Diamonds Are Forever. They do the words. And we're going to put a little bit of the silver glitter dust in as well. Because I like glitter.
Blingy crucifix.
It's a blingy cross. So we're going to feed this into this cross shape that we've created. So pigmented this silver is. It's delicious. Don't eat it then. It's not edible. Once you've done that, pick up a clear bead, press it into the glitter. Then we're going to make this even more sparkly by adding glitter. Once you've got your glitter in, we're going to encapsulate that with clear. Let that set a little bit, and then we can pinch. Right, I'm going to go in with the pinching tool. Test pinch it first, take it off, make sure it's not being crushed. Nope, we're good to go. Pop that on. And you can always pinch the length as well with your thumb and finger, or finger and... Well, if you're doing it on somebody else, you can use both your thumbs. It's always good to have even pressure. So when you pinch, if you're doing it on somebody else, it's a lot easier to just pinch with both of your thumbs. I'm just going to take the form off now. So I'm just going to open the back and release. Ta-da! And then I can file. I'm going to file in my normal filing routine. So side wall first. Get those nice and straight. And then the cuticle area. Get that free edge nice and straight there, and then you can contour the rest of the nail. So once you've filed it into shape, what you'll find is when you file, you'll hit each colour and it'll sharpen everything up as well. And I'm going to buff this, make it nice and smooth, like a baby's ass, or a baby's forehead that's been christened. Hey, this would be a good christening design, wouldn't it be?
Christening design, oh my God.
Yeah? If you're having your baby christened, you'd have a little cross, like, eh?
She's finding God at the moment, by the way.
I'm finding God, I'm really am. Dust that off. We're going to wipe over with the acetone, just to make it even smoother. Give that a rub-a-dub-dub. Oh, goddamn, goddamn. I'm going to apply mega gloss to this. So really bring out the sparkle. Pop that in the lamp. Right, so now we're going to tie this in to the other designs by putting some snow on, a bit of snow. And we're going to use Snow White. You'll need white acrylic powder as well. So I'm going to do it as if the snow is sat on top of the cross. Like it's just gathered on top. I'll do some here. Then we're going to do some little dots as if it's snowflakes just falling. Once you've done that, white powder, so mega white, and then just sprinkle that all over. Make sure you get enough on. If you don't put enough on, it won't be as textured. We want this to look really textured against that shiny surface as well. Tap off the excess and bang it in the lamp. And I'm just going to dust off the excess now. There'll be no sticky layer to clean off because the acrylic absorbs that. Now, because I like a bit of bling, we're going to add a little bit of bling. I'm going to put it on with mega gloss, so Gonna work here first in the center part. I'm going to pop that into the lamp now. Oh, I think that really shows it off, doesn't it? That is gorgeous. I'm loving the fact that it's on my finger. So that's like super blingy glam meets
God.
God. Glam meets God. Oh my God, it is glam meets God with a bit of snow thrown in. What do you think? I love it. So yo guys, hope you've enjoyed that video. Don't forget to watch the next video where I totally complete the look. You need to see it. It's a must watch. See you later guys. Bye bye.